Last week, then, we took our first look at the full stack idea of web development, and we began by writing a web API, so a web service written in ASP.NET. And what we're going to look at this week is writing the other end of that, the front end, which I'm going to write in Angular to pick up that data and to display it in an Angular application, most of which we actually already wrote in an earlier video. But let's start out by taking a look at what's happening on the back end, just as a reminder. So remember, if we run this up, we get the Swagger page that shows us those endpoints. So we've got the get all, the get one, we've got the post, the put and delete for the four CRUD operations of create, read, update and delete. And so, for example, if I just do the get there and try it out and execute, then we get our full listing of all the data that we had in the SQLite database on the back end. So now I want to hook that up to the front end. So we'll leave that running. We don't really need to have the Swagger page up there open, but we need the server running. That's an important thing. And let's then move on to VS Code, where I've got the Angular application. And again, let's just run that up so we can remind ourselves where we were. And so you can see we've got a full listing of all of those titles and ratings. And then on the summary page, we took the same data and summarized it, so you get the average rating for each book title. And what I've added there is this little add review. So we can add a new rating. So if I say put in Emma in there and gave that a rating of 3, then it doesn't do anything at the moment, but that's the feature that we're going to be putting in when we start using the real data. So that's what we've got. But the data in the Angular app at the moment is just fake data. So if we look in services in the book review repository service, that's where we can see we've actually got fake data. We're not getting it from the back end. So that's what we're going to do. The very first thing we're going to do is just get into our Angular application the necessary libraries, the modules that are going to allow us to connect to a back end. So if we go into the app module and then in the imports, I'm going to add this HTTP client module. That's the thing we need. And then an odd thing to note here, normally VS Code is really good at finding what it needs to import to get hold of any particular module. But for some reason, I've seen this in lots of situations, just for this one, it doesn't know where to get it from. And so we're gonna have to do that for ourselves. So it's easy enough to look up in the documentation online, but we want to import our HTTP client module. And it comes from @angular/common/HTTP. Okay, so that now means that it's accepting that HTTP client module. So that's got the library that we need in there. Then we need to start using that in our book review repository service. And so we're going to do the hard part first, which is just delete that existing mock set of data. And then what I'll do is I'll put in here a private, and we'll just call this reviews. And we'll make that an array of book review. So we already had this simple class book review that has the same data structure as what we're getting from the server. And then we'll also initialize that to an empty array. And then we'll make it so that that get reviews returns simply this dot reviews. And then to populate it, we're going to start with the constructor. And we're going to inject into the constructor the object that we get from that HTTP client module. So we'll say private HTTP client, and then that is of type HTTP client. And click that. And so remember that private means, as well as taking this into the constructor, we're also going to create a private field called HTTP client, which will be initialized. And that's what we're going to use. So then what we'll do is we'll put in a private method. So this is going to be called load reviews. And then it's going to return void. And then in here, we're going to say this.httpclient.get, because we're trying to make the get call back on the API service. And then get is a generic, so we can actually specify the data type we're going to get back, which we know wants to be array of book review. So we can put that in there. And that means that when the data comes in, purely in a JSON format, so that's the format that we saw when we were looking at this in Swagger, it will map that onto our data structure that we want. And so I do that, and then I need to pass in the URI from which we're going to get that data. So we know we're sending a GET request, but where are we going to send it? And, well, we can get that from, again, what we have here in the Swagger. So we're going to copy most of that. So let's take that as a starting point and paste that in. But obviously we don't want to look at the Swagger. We want to go directly down to the controller. And that, remember, is called simply book review. So that was the name of our controller minus the word controller. And so that is going to make our GET request. Little bit sloppy here in that really we shouldn't be hard coding things like that directly into our code. We should have some sort of config file. We'll look at how to do that in Angular in a later video, but that's how we can make the request. But then we hit a problem that you always get when you are making requests back to a server. We won't get that data back immediately. It's going to take a finite amount of time to send the request over to the server, for the server to process it, and then for the response to come back. And what we don't want is for our application in the browser to sit there waiting for that response and for it to block up and not be responsive to any other user input. And we looked at this in a video a good while back when we looked at the idea of JavaScript promises, which are a way that we can separate that idea of when we send the request from when we get it back. Now, promises available in JavaScript, therefore also available in TypeScript, but they're not actually what Angular tends to use. Angular uses a thing called an observable, which is conceptually very like a promise in that it delays the response from the request, but it does it in a rather more flexible and advanced way. We're not going to look at all of those details this time. I'm planning another video on that because observables are absolutely huge when you're programming Angular, but let's just use it in this simple case. So what we do here is we say dot subscribe. So we are going to start listening to the response coming in from that request, even though it's not going to come in immediately. And when it does come in, subscribe will give us a result. So we use an arrow function. If we just hover over a result, we can see it's of type book review array, precisely what we expected because we put that in as the generic. And so given we've got the book review array, all we need to do with that is say this.reviews equals result. And so as soon as the data comes in, we will put it into the reviews. And then because of the whole cycle that we have in Angular of change detection, as soon as that changes, then the get reviews will change and any component that's looking at that, like the ones that we've got, will change as well. The one thing we've got to remember to do, of course, is call this now from the constructor. So we say this.loadReviews, and that will kick the whole thing off as soon as we get started. And then that book repository service, remember, is injected into our component. So in our AllReviews component, we've got that in there. And it's also injected into the review summary service, which is where we did that calculation of the averages. So if we just do a save all on that, we can see that it rebuilds. And then if we look at the browser, well, we can see it's obviously not worked because we've got complete blank in those listings. And actually, if I just bring up the console, we can see we're getting an error and it says it's been blocked by the CORS policy. Now, CORS, CRS, stands for Cross-Origin Resource Sharing. And this is a deliberate security policy that's applied by the browser and the server in combination. And the point is, if you have a really simple website where you've both got your web pages, your HTML being generated, and your web service residing on the same server at the same URI, then that is permissible that the one can talk to the other. But what we've got here is actually two separate URIs. So we've got the Angular app, which is on localhost 4200. Obviously, they're all localhost here, but they could be anything on the web. And then we've also got our API, which is at 5001. So these are completely separate sites as far as the system's concerned. And so when we send a request from 4200 to 5001, it's just not allowed because that's the default security setting. So what we need to do is make a change to the way we've configured our API. And what we do in startup, we need to go in here, and then just after we've configured the Swagger, we need to configure this for allowing this other site to have access to the API. And so what we do is this. We say services dot and then add cause. So this is going to set up our cause policy. And then we have some options. And we're going to say options dot add policy. We then give that policy a name. So I'm going to call this local origins policy. You can call it what you like. You can have multiple ones of these, actually, but we're just going to have the one of them. And then we specify what that policy is all about. And so we say builder gives, and then builder dot. And I am going to be absolutely relaxed about this. In a serious application, you might want to consider a bit more about this, but I'm going to say allow any origin. So that means whatever the URI of the site this is coming from, it will be allowed. You would more normally, certainly if you want high security, be specifying precisely where you want to allow it. So I could have put the localized 4200 in there, but I'm just going to say allow any origin. I'm also going to say allow any method. So put, post, delete, get. Again, we might want different policies, so you might want to be more relaxed about reading data than writing data, but we're going for that. And then I'm also going to put allow any header. So it's going to allow any information in the header on there. So then if I do that, that should have configured us in a pretty slack way, but it'll get things going. One other thing I've got to do, having configured cause there, I've got to use cause. So down here in the configure, I'm just going to have app.use cause. And then I've got to remember to pass in there the same policy name that I had in there. So that's our local origins policy. So let's run that up again. And then let's go back to our application. And you can see it's now showing that data. There's a tiny little pause there. That, remember, is because it's got to go to the API server, get the result, bring it back on that subscribe, on the observable. And so you can see we've got the data there. And if we then go to the summary, you can see that it's got the summary data, because that's just taken that same data that we had before. And so that's the basic use of the get working. Let's now do our add review, just so we can see how we can use a post. So we had this in here. And so what I'm going to do there is let's go to that component. So here we've got our add review component. And you can see it's got the title and the rating. Those are data bound to the title and the rating that we've got in there. You can see until we put something in there, the add is disabled. So all we need to do basically on this add review, which is where we press the button, what we need to do is make a call to actually post some data. So let's go to the repository service and we'll add a new method in here. So we'll have an add review. And that's going to take as a parameter a single book review. That's going to return void. And then we're going to say this dot HTTP client, and this time it's dot post. We don't really care what we're going to get back from the post. We'll talk about error conditions. So if something went wrong on the server, we'll talk about that both on the server side and the client side later on. I'm saying so much we're going to look at later on, but this is a big topic, so I'm trying to build it up in small parts. But we'll have that, and then we pass into the post, well, again, exactly the same URL. This is the nice thing about a RESTful API, that the URL is usually the same or similar. It's the verb, get or post, that makes the difference. But because this is a post, we've also got to provide what it is we're posting. Well, that's easy. We have the review. So that will post it off, and that should fit in. Again, if we look at the Swagger, that should be doing basically what we had with the post in there. But we've still got to worry about how we respond to that, because at the moment what will happen is we will post it, it will change it on the server, but we haven't done anything to refresh the client to show the new result. So what we want to do is, having done the post, we want to reload the reviews. But we don't want to do that immediately. If we just here said this dot load reviews, then the problem would be that this bit of code would get called before the reviews had had time to be updated and refreshed, and so we'd just get the same data as before. So again, we can use a subscribe here. So what we do is here we say dot subscribe, so this will only be called when the response comes back. Now, we're not particularly interested in the response, just that we get one. So we'll just call that result, but we don't care what it is. But what we do care about is that when we get the result, that is when we reload the reviews. So once the server is up to date, we then want to reload the reviews, and that will redisplay them. And then, of course, the one last thing we've got to do is we've got to go to our add review component, and we've got to call that. So that means that firstly, we need to do some more injection. So we need to inject our book review repository service. Let's just nick that from there. So we'll put that into our all reviews. And then obviously get hold of the import. Because it's private, it's been made a member. So then all we've got to do here is before we do that emit, we say this dot book review repository service dot add review. Then we can just add in an object of type book review. So remember, book review has a title, which we're going to set to this.title. And then it has a rating, which we're going to set to this.rating. And then that should have sent the data off to the repository service. And then when the post comes back, we'll get the result. So if we save that, and then go to our browser, and now let's add a review. Let's add a review for Emma. Give Emma a rating of 3. Click add. And we can see it took a moment because it's got to make that round trip to the server. But there we can see we've got Emma with a rating of 3. If we switch to the summary, that means that the average rating for Emma has gone up to 4. Let's just prove that. So if we do another review for Emma with a 5, there we get the new review. But if we now look at the summary, we can see it's gone up to 4.17. So that's all working correctly. So we've got there the very basics of a full stack client server application. We've got a .NET web API that's managing the database, providing the data, and then we've got an Angular front end that's reading that data, writing that data, and therefore allowing us to display the data that's coming all the way through from the database. There is still much, much more to do. We've got a basic program there, but things we've got to do, quite importantly, we've got to deal with error conditions. What if I were to try and create a review with a rating that was negative or that was greater than 5 or something like that? That shouldn't be allowed, and that's got to be protected on both the server and the client. But also, we've got to have a big look at what we do with these observables. So I've shown you this in the most simple way that we can have, where we've got this subscribe, but there is so much more that we can do with observables. In programming terms, I find them about the most fascinating thing I do in Angular and in TypeScript, so I'm hoping to do quite a few more videos on that. But hopefully that was helpful to get things started. We've got the full flow going now. If you enjoyed that, do click like, do subscribe, and I'll see you next time.